We asked people on the street, if evolution is true, how did male and female come about? And we got some interesting responses. Let's take a look at those right now.
I don't know. Just nature in general? I mean, as a species, there has to be different, you know, male and female, so.
I think evolution is true. Well, we probably got males and females by accident because some species actually don't need males and females.
Oh, that's like, that's basic. Like, obviously, you have to have, for like sexual selection, you need to have two different sets of gametes. You have to have a way for them to come together. So you have to have male and female reproductive systems to create the genetic diversity that has kind of led to humanity, to all speciation.
I guess like reproduction had to go from splitting cells into two to something else, you know?
I don't know, it's just different species of the planet. I mean, it's some were created one way, some were created the other way, you know? Or they evolved to be one way.
The man came first, okay? Here's how it happened. The man came first and God said, let's split your rib and make a woman. So there you go.
You know, and there's common threads running through all of those responses. And most who believe in evolution, when questioned about this specific problem, they'll say, well, it had to happen. So it happened.
I heard no explanations for how it happened.
No.
Except the one who gave the Genesis one answer.
The Genesis, because we actually have a historical record of how it happened.
And that to me is a great question. Student comes home from college, no mom and dad, no grandma and grandpa, evolution's the way it is. Well, how do you explain male and female? And you can't. Evolution is impossible. It's a really strong rejoinder to say, if evolution happens step by step, who came first, male or female? Mm-hmm. And they have to be there at the same time, essentially an evolutionary miracle. And it's not just a physical male, a physical female. It's all the molecular structures involved in sperm and egg. It's a massive miracle. It has to occur all at the same time, coming together at the right sequence, in the right matched parts, or evolution's dead in the water, because evolution has to explain it.
You're saying that evolution requires, as we know it, requires miracles?
If evolution tries to explain everything, there are certain structures like male and female. They're interdependent. You can't have sexual reproduction without both. Evolution's done.
Okay.
And that's what evolutionists, if they're honest, if they know this, they'll say, well, the best answer they'll have is it's a research question. So now we're on the sequence of walking back, grandma and grandpa, mom and dad, you're wrong.
Yes.
Well, let me say, hold on. Evolution's impossible. How do you explain male and female? Well, I don't know. And this is now the sequence of events that'll be followed. Whatever they open with mm-hmm. to say, here's why you're wrong, you can come back with, well, it's impossible. Or,
yeah.
To me, one of the best ways to engage people is not necessarily just to contradict, but to ask questions. And that makes them think, and I don't know, as the opening person on the street there illustrated, I don't know.
I'm not sure. Yeah.
Don't have the answer.
Yeah.
Well, the next step they'll typically take then to prove their case, especially if it's a student with a strong sense of I'm right and my old fogey parents are wrong, mm-hmm. is, well, there's just so much evidence for it. All the evidence supports evolution. We've just learned through the textbooks, all these scientists saying this is the evidence for evolution.
Okay.
And the problem with that is, what can a parent, a grandparent say in response to that? The evidence hasn't changed in 150 years.
Right.
What has changed is the responses to it. And what we've discovered over time is all the evidence for evolution fit creation equally well.